Good morning to all. So I'm going to give my presentation on applause identification and its relevance to archive of Carnatic music audio recordings. So generally speaking, an applause is an indication of appreciation which is given to the performer. The performer may be a singer or a speaker or a violinist or mridanganist. That depends upon the context. So here, if I'm moving to the outline of my presentation, so first I'll talk about Carnatic music concert and what is the relationship between this concert and applause identification. Then I'm trying to define my problem definition in terms of how what is the need for identifying an applause with respect to Carnatic music concert. So once I define my problem definition, then I'll talk about what are the features I'm going to extract in order to discriminate between music and applause. So once I define my features, so I know the locations of applauses in a given concert, so how to characterize those applauses in order to find out the highlights of the Carnatic music concert. So there I'm going to use a technique called cumulative sum technique, which will allow me to process the applause locations based on the features what I'm extracting, so in such a way that I can able to identify different types of highlights in a Carnatic music concert. Then I'll talk about some results which I got based on threshold wise as well as cumulative sum technique. If you move on to Carnatic music concert, so typically a concert can be 2 to 3 hours long. So in this concert can have different types of pieces. So various pieces it has. So till now, most of the Carnatic music concerts which are archived today, those are manually segmented into pieces, and those segments are stored in the database. Or else, the entire audio recording is stored as a single recording in the database. That is what is happening in context of Carnatic music concerts. If you, in a concert, audience applauds the artist after end of every piece. Sometimes when the performer is, or when the singer is singing improvisational aspects, in such a case, audience will applaud the artist within the piece itself. So in the context of my problem, what I'm defining is, if applause is end of piece, I'm taking it as intra-piece applause. If it is within piece, I'm taking it as intra-piece applause. So for this context, I'm defining those two types of applauses, inter-piece and intra-piece applauses. So now I'm trying to define my problem definition. We have seen the relationship between Carnatic music concert and applause identification. So now I'm trying to define my problem definition as, if I'm able to identify inter-piece applause locations, that will help me to segment the 3 hours concert or 4 hour concert into different types of pieces. Those pieces, you can store it in database. That's the first advantage of identifying the applauses. Whereas moving to the second one, if I identify the location of applauses, I'll do some sort of processing such a way that it will identify me huge applause. Wherever huge applauses are there, that indicates the highlights of the concert. So I'm using a cumulative sum technique for that, you know, to identify the huge applauses in a given concert. So based on that, I'm trying to identify the highlights. This is my problem definition. Before moving to my feature extraction and all, you'll see what is the existing work on applause identification. The first paper discusses how the applauses are identified in speech meeting. So in speech meeting, when the speaker is talking, he is giving speech, so you can identify the applauses for those are indication of important points of the speech meeting. So if you are able to identify those applause locations, you can give the highlights of that speech meeting. So whereas coming to the second paper, so they are using the different types of features in order to segment the whole audio recording into speech, music, and different types of environmental sounds like laughter, cheers, applause, etc. So once you know the location of all these segments, you can apply for audio information retrieval. So whereas third paper, it discusses where the applause is detected in a football game. If you identify in a football game, if you identify the applause locations, that indicates the highlights of the game. So this is the existing work on applause identification, but there is no work currently on applause identification with respect to Carnatic music. So if you see the characteristics of music and applause in time domain representation, so So here, these are the applause segments. These are the music segments. So in time domain, you can able to discriminate between applause and music, but that discrimination is not significant. So if you move to the spectral domain representation of applause, these are the applause same segments. These are music segments. So if you see these applause segments, those are more or less flat. If you see these segments, it has some structure. So can I process these spectral domain features such a way that it will allow me to discriminate between applause and music? So there comes through feature extraction process. So here I'm making use of spectral domain features, spectral flux and spectral entropy to discriminate between applause and music. If you move on to spectral flux, it says how quickly the power spectrum is changing between adjacent frames. So here I'm calculating this spectral flux with respect to adjacent frames. So when I'm calculating this with respect to adjacent frames, I need a normalization. So here I'm experimented with three different types of normalization with respect to spectral flux. So first one is I'm calculating spectral flux without any normalization, and I'm calculating spectral flux with power spectral density normalization, and then I'm making use of peak normalization. So if you see the figures, this is a music segment. So this is applause segment, this is a music segment. In this case, for example sake I have taken, this music segment is having only singing voice. It is not having any instruments. So if I calculate spectral flux without normalization, so this is a discrimination I'm getting. So here I can able to discriminate between applause as well as music segment. If I'm moving to power spectral density normalization, so that discrimination is not significant. If I move to spectral flux with peak normalization, this I can simply put a hard threshold to discriminate between applause and music. So these are the two features I'm going to work with: spectral flux with no normalization, spectral flux with peak normalization for my experiments. If you move to spectral entropy, it identifies the randomness of the signal, or how the signal is disordered with respect to time. So if you see the same example, so if you see the spectral entropy, I can simply put a hot threshold in order to discriminate between applause and music segments. So database, I have used 19 concerts of male and female singer, and then all concerts are vocal, lead musician is a singer, and each concert has 15 to 20 applauses. For all 19 concerts, I have 343 applauses total. So for all 19 concerts, I have extracted spectral flux as well as spectral entropy. So for a window size of 25 milliseconds with an overlap of 10 milliseconds, so which has a sampling frequency 44.1K. So extracted features for all 19 concerts, I'm smoothing by making use of a rectangular filter with length 15. So I need some sort of ground truth to find out the accuracy of my techniques. So for all 19 concerts, applause locations and type of applause, whether interpiece or intrapiece, so those are manually marked by musician. So here Vignesh has marked for me. So based on that ground truth, I'm trying to plot the DAT curve for all the applause, for all 19 concerts, as well as I have calculated equal error rates for 19 concerts. If you see the DAT curve, so here I plotted the DAT curve for different types of thresholds. So for a particular threshold, I have calculated the equal error rates. So here, spectral entropy is giving me 17.33% accuracy compared to these two different types of techniques. So this is, I have plotted the spectral flux and the spectral entropy features for a whole 3 hours concert. This is Abhishek Raghuram concert. This is a 3 hours concert. So this is a spectral flux features. These are spectral entropy features. These peaks will indicate that applause locations. Even here, these peaks will indicate that applause locations. So here, if I want to identify which is a huge applause, so a simple threshold technique won't help me to find out the huge applauses. So that's the reason, first I'll show you the figure, and then I'll talk about a cue-sum technique. So previously I showed three figures. So this is spectral flux with no normalization. This is peak normalization. This is spectral entropy. For these three segments, I'm calculating cumulative sum technique. This cumulative sum technique will work like this. Suppose here, this is a discrimination between music and applause. If I'm subtracting mean from this, if I'm able to subtract mean from this, this will never become negative. Whereas coming to this, this will become negative. So my implementation is, I'm trying to subtract mean from every sample. After subtracting, if that value is greater than zero, I'll just summing up. If it is less than zero, I'll make it as zero. So if I'm doing in such a way, so this is the way I'm getting. So wherever applause is there, starting of triangle, wherever applause ends, their triangle is ending. So start of a triangle and end of triangle will indicate the applause location as well as duration. And strength of an applause also you can see how strength this applause is. So similarly, here also if I'm subtracting some mean from it, so this won't become negative, whereas this will become negative. Whenever it is becoming negative, I'm making it as zero. So in these three techniques, I have used these three techniques for threshold-based identification, but here, spectral flux with no normalization, it is other way around. So whenever, if I'm subtracting mean from it, whenever applause is there, it is giving me zeros. Whenever applause is not there, it is giving me triangles. So because of that, I'm taking these two, spectral flux and spectral entropy, for identifying the highlights of the concert. So if you see the algorithm for Q-sum technique, so X of n is my feature, either it is spectral flux or spectral entropy. So where a is a parameter, that parameter I'm setting it as mean of that entire feature. So this parameter I'm subtracting from every sample. After subtracting, if that value is greater than zero, I'm just summing up. If it is less than zero, I'm making it as zero. So this is the algorithm you have seen previously. So if you see the its implementation, previously, we have seen this as a spectral flux and spectral entropy. If I'm computing Q-sum values, clearly you can see wherever peaks are there, that is an indication of applause locations. So after applying Q-sum technique completely, wherever peaks are there, that is an indication of duration and strength of an applause. So here, spectral flux, I have some spurious values, even though I have subtracted Q-sum, but I have to set the threshold, how much I have to subtract. So currently, I have subtracted 1.2% of mean. If I increase that, I have to experiment empirically, I have to choose that value. If I choose that value correctly, even I won't get these spurious values. If you're coming to entropy, 1.2% of mean, it works fine. That's the reason I'm getting only peak values. Those are the, here you have 22 triangles are there. In the 20 triangles are applause locations. So can I make use of this strength and duration of an applause for identifying the highlights of the concert? So here I have taken Q-sum values of 19 concerts in order to find out the duration and strength of an applause. Based on duration and strength of an applause, you have taken top three. We have taken top three highlights for all 19 concerts. So based on those top three highlights, based on top three peaks, so we found out that these are the different types of highlights for all 19 concerts, based on spectral flux as well as based on spectral entropy. So here, spectral flux will give me some highlights, and spectral entropy will give me some highlights. So based on both the features, how many different types of highlights I can able to identify? So these are the different types of highlights I'm able to identify. So we observed that after Thaniya Vartanam, where Mrudangam Solo is performing, so we identify very huge applauses are there. So this we have identified also manually by Vignesh and myself. So if I'm moving to a conclusion, so we are able to discriminate between music and applause based on spectral flux and spectral entropy features. That will help me to locate the applause locations. By using Q-sum technique, so we are able to identify the highlights of the applause. So almost you have captured so many number of highlights for 19 concerts. Our goal will be, if I'm combining these two features, can I able to increase my accuracy? Or as I 17.33% I got accuracy because whenever Ghatam Solo is playing, in such a case I'm getting more misclassifications. So whenever Ghatam is improvisation is there, in such a case, so my entropy and flux both are giving those locations as applause locations. So can I do some sort of post-processing in such a way that it will get rid of those misclassifications? So that I have to look into it. Then currently we have worked with the digital recorders of 19 concerts of 9 singers almost. Now we have to work with a large database with different recorders. So these are my references. So any questions?